Well, today's quote comes from a mother who writes, "I want my children to have all the things I couldn't afford, and then I want to move in with them." Today we're up to the next title in the Litany of St. Joseph. Again, once a week I try to talk about St. Joseph during this great year of grace honoring St. Joseph. The invocation today is St. Joseph, Most Courageous. Another translation is St. Joseph, Most Strong, or St. Joseph, Most Valiant. What a great word that is. St. Joseph was valiant. The word courageous, courage, comes from the Latin word cor, meaning the heart. So it means having strength of heart, fortitude, which is one of the four cardinal virtues, to have this bravery in time of danger, this strength in time of difficulty. And we know, of course, that St. Joseph must have been physically very strong because Scripture calls him a tecton, which is a carpenter. Carpenters had to go out and cut down their own trees. So St. Joseph was as strong as a lumberjack, I like to say. Imagine how strong he was to cut down the trees, to carry them back, and to make, you know, plows and tables and houses out of that wood. But carpenters in those days, tectons, were really more stonemasons. They worked with stone, granite, limestone. They were builders. So imagine how strong St. Joseph must have been physically. Plus, he had to walk a great deal. Every male over a certain age, I think over 18, had to walk to Jerusalem 3 times a year for the great festivals like Passover and Tabernacles, the Feast of Booths, and the three major pilgrimages. So St. Joseph had to walk, and then, of course, to flee to Egypt from Bethlehem to either Alexandria, where a large Jewish community, or to Cairo. Imagine Our Lady would have been on a donkey, and St. Joseph would have had to walk. And as I mentioned before, as Mother Angelica said on a call-in TV show, "Mother Angelica, was St. Joseph young or old?" She said, "Sweetie, old men don't walk to Egypt." So imagine he had to be quite young and strong. But then we see the courage and the valor of St. Joseph at the moment that the angel told Joseph to take Mary, his wife, into his home. They had been officially married. They were betrothed, which was officially considered a marriage in the eyes of God and the eyes of the community. But there was a 1-year waiting period before a couple was allowed to live together. During that year, the husband would build the house that the wife was going to live in. And then after this year, they'd have a big party, a 7-day festival, marriage ceremony, and a celebration for 7 days. But since Mary was with child, it says Joseph immediately took her into his home. This was to shield Mary, to protect her from having a bad name or bad reputation. And really, St. Joseph showed his moral courage by allowing people to think bad about himself. In other words, what he would indicate by taking Mary, his wife, into his home is that the two of them had not been chaste, that they had engaged in marital relations, and they were allowed to do that, but it was not the practice. Normally, it was a 1-year waiting period. So when Joseph took Mary into his home, it would shield Mary, protect her good name and reputation, but he himself would be considered unchaste. Isn't it interesting that the most chaste man who ever lived was considered, he couldn't wait till marriage to have relations with his wife. And so he was willing to show that great moral courage in order to defend and protect Our Lady's good name and reputation. And he took Mary immediately into his home, which of course meant that they could not have the big wedding celebration, the 7-day party. They had to forego all of that. But out of obedience, Joseph showed this great love of Our Lady and this great courage in protecting her. And then we see on the flight into Egypt how strong and courageous and valiant St. Joseph must have been. As Father Calloway writes, he knew that he would have to defend his wife and child against physical assaults on their way to Egypt and living in Egypt. He writes, "Egypt was a land notorious for thieves, pagan rituals, idols, and sorcerers." So St. Joseph was so strong that he was willing, if needed, to defend the life of Our Lady and the Christ child with his own life, being willing to lay down his life for his family. That's how courageous and strong he was, going into this pagan territory, and then took a lot of courage to, again, move to Egypt for probably 7 years to set up shop, to work again as a carpenter and a stonemason in Egypt, until God told him to come back to Israel, to the Holy Land. So we see his tremendous courage and valor throughout the time in Egypt, being willing to defend his child and Mary against the evils of the Egyptian society. And lastly, it makes a good point, Father Calloway mentions, that Jesus himself must have learned courage from the example of Saint Joseph and witnessed his father's courage in Egypt and Nazareth and Jerusalem and any place they traveled together. Saint Joseph gave his son an example of manly love, courage, strength, and fortitude. With Saint Joseph as your spiritual father, you have nothing to be afraid of. So don't be afraid of poor health. Don't be afraid of losing a job. Don't be afraid of difficulties, because Saint Joseph is there. He is courageous. He is filled with valor and with strength. And I believe that when our Lord was going through his passion, he thought about Saint Joseph. When he went through the agony in the garden, taking upon himself the sins of the world, he would have thought, how did my father handle his suffering? And Jesus not only had God, his heavenly father, he even said, Father, let this chalice pass me by, but not my will, but thine be done. In the agony in the garden, he would have thought about Saint Joseph. How would he have handled this suffering? And Jesus emulated his foster father. When Jesus was being scourged at the pillar, he probably thought, how would my dad have dealt with this? How had my father dealt with being crowned with thorns and ridiculed and spit upon in the crowning with thorns? How had my father Joseph, how would he have carried the cross? And when Jesus was being crucified, he probably thought, again, how would my foster father Saint Joseph have dealt with this? And it was the training, the example, the education, the witness of Saint Joseph that was such a powerful strengthening of Christ during his passion. So we pray today, Saint Joseph, most courageous, pray for us.